as the ocean, loving kindness as the flood. When the Prince of Life, our ransom, shed for us His precious blood. When the Prince of Life, our ransom, shed for us His precious blood. Who His love will not remember? Who can cease to sing His praise? He can never be forgotten throughout hell's eternal days. Yes, Lord. Crucifixion, fountains open deep and wide. Through the floodgates of God's mercy flowed a vast and gracious tide. Grace and love like mighty rivers poured in from above. Heaven's peace and perfect justice kissed the guilt. World in love, who His love will not remember, who can cease to sing His praise, He can never be forgotten throughout hell's eternal days.
Behold, bless the Lord, all you servants of the Lord, who by night stand in the house of the Lord. Lift up your hands in the sanctuary and bless the Lord who made heaven and earth. Bless you from Zion. I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and welcome each of you to this morning online English worship service, Church of Christ, Union Church, Bhubaneswar. We are so glad that you are watching online and being part of this online worship service. Come, let us bow before the Lord, committing ourselves, committing the rest of the service into the hand of the Lord. Let us seek His face together. Shall we pray? Dear Lord, we are so thankful to You, and we want to lift Your name high this morning. We praise You and worship Your God, because You are the only true and living God. You have created us, and also You have redeemed us by the precious blood of Your only Son, Jesus Christ. This morning, as Your people, Lord, we bow before You in worship and in adoration. Lord, we praise Your holy name. We are so thankful to You, O Lord, for every blessings in which You have blessed us. You have sustained our life. Lord, You have took very good care of us during the past days. You have delivered us from all sorts of difficulties, dangers, from distractions. Lord, You have healed our sicknesses. You have heard our prayers. And Lord, You have granted us with a lot of blessings. Lord, we want to praise Your holy name. This morning, as Your people, as we gather together, even though, Lord, we are scattered here and there, we are in our own homes, but we know that we are in Your presence, because You are there with us wherever we are. And therefore, O Lord, we bless Your holy name. We worship You, O Lord, and we commit this entire worship service into Your hand. We commit ourselves into Your hand. Bless us together, O Lord. Be with us and speak to us, guide us and lead us. For We offer this prayer in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us worship the Lord by singing a hymn. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground sinking sand. Let us worship the Lord as we sing this hymn.
count on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. Darkness seems to hide his face. I rest on his unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. On Christ the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. His oath, his covenant, his blood support me in the whelming flood. When all around my soul gives way, he then is all my hope and stay. On Christ the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. When he shall come with trumpet sound, oh, may I then in him be found, dressed in his righteousness alone. Solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. On Christ the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand.
The scripture portion for our morning meditation is taken from Book of Deuteronomy, chapter 33, verses 26 and 27. Book of Deuteronomy, chapter 33, verses 26 and 27. I am reading from New King James Version, and you may kindly follow your own versions. There is no one like the God of Jeshurun, who rides the heavens to help you, and in his excellency on the clouds. The eternal God is your refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. He will thrust out the enemy from before you, and will say, destroy. We will continue to worship our God by singing another hymn, God so loved the world. God so loved the world. As we sing this hymn, let us bring our special offerings, our thanksgiving offerings, our tithes to the Lord. Whatever we have separated for Him, let us bring it to His feet. Those who are able to pay through online, you may continue to do so. And we are so thankful to you for doing it. All the brothers and sisters, those who have done it during the past weeks, you may continue to do so. And those who are unable to pay through online, you may kindly keep your offerings separate in an envelope. When the lockdown will be over, when we will be able to gather together, you may bring it. But for your help, our deacons will be available in the church premises every Monday and Friday from 8:30 to 9:30 in the morning. You may kindly bring your offering and hand it over to them and take the receipt instantly.
For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, whosoever believes will not perish, they shall have eternal life. I shall hold to the cross. I shall hold to God alone, for His love has salvaged me. For His love has set me free. For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, and whosoever believes will not perish, they shall have eternal life. I shall wait upon the Lord. I shall wait upon His word. By His grace I am released. By His grace I am redeemed. For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, whosoever believes will not perish, they shall have shall have eternal life.
I have couple of announcements to make. The last week of this month, especially from 27th till 1st of August, the church is launching out a program called web series. It is called Battling Negativity #COVID-19, dealing with various issues that depresses people, various difficulties that people are going through. This special program will be telecast through YouTube channel in our website, and you may kindly watch it, and also you can share the link to your friends.
Someone had said, loneliness is like a piano without a keys, like a violin without strings. Loneliness is like a sanctuary without congregation. It's like a choir where nobody is singing.
Jesus came into this world to give life, and life in all its beauty, in abundance. Even death could not stop him. He was victorious over death.
The all-powerful, the all-knowing, the all-seeing God, the awesome God who calls every star of the sky by name, knows you personally, although you do not know him. The very hairs of your head are numbered, and he knows you by name.
The grave is not the end for the Christian, and that is the greatest news. For those who don't know Christ, for them, death is a calamity, it is a disaster. For you and me, if we are believers in Christ, death holds the glorious hope of heaven. A believer's life, always a giving life. And actually, world teaches us to preserve, to save, but Bible teaches us to give out of whatever we have.
We never know what lies ahead tomorrow, but this is not to paint a grim picture. It is just to remind us that time moves on at a frantic pace. We have things that come and go, but let us remember one thing, that the chart and compass for our life must come from God Almighty, who will pilot us through the most treacherous areas of life, and that's the promise God wants to give you today.
Church of Christ Union Church has organized a series of talks focusing on the situation that we are passing through right now because of the coronavirus pandemic. What you just saw is a glimpse of it. This program is meant to infuse hope in our lives during this situation. This project has been an incredible ride, and we would love you to be part of it.
Let us pray for the brothers and sisters, those who seek our prayers. And also, last week and during this week, several brothers and sisters, those who are celebrating their birthdays, we will pray for them. We will pray for the offering, and also we will pray for other issues. So let us look to the Lord in prayer. Dear Lord, once again we bow before you. We want to thank you and praise you that you have given us this wonderful opportunity before your presence to worship you. I do pray for every family, so Lord, every individuals, those who are in their homes, here in this city, throughout Odisha, and in our country, as well as in abroad. All the brothers and sisters, those who are watching this and becoming part of this worship service, bless each of them, O Lord. Hear their prayers, and Lord, answer them. Help them, O Lord. Protect them wherever they are. Dear Lord, we also want to thank you and praise you for our dear brothers and sisters, those who have celebrated their birthdays during the past week, and also some of them who are going to celebrate during this week. We pray for P.P. Matthews, who celebrated his birthday on 8th July. Bless that brother, and Lord, bless him in his studies and bless him in this new year. Lord, we want to thank you and praise you for brother Sanjeev Kumar Das, who celebrated his birthday on 11th. And Lord, continue to bless your servant and his family. Thank you also, Lord, for Sister Dhirarani Supakar. She also celebrated her birthday on 12th. Lord, bless her abundantly. We thank you and praise you for Sister Sunita Pani, Brother Michael Behera, son of our elder Reverend Stephen Behera. And Lord, they also have celebrated their birthday on 13th. Bless them abundantly, O Lord. Thank you also, Lord, for Sister Ellen Pramanik. She has celebrated her birthday on 15th. And also Sister Gyanoda Das. She also has celebrated her birthday on 15th. Lord, bless them abundantly. And may your presence continue to guide them and protect them. Lord, we want to thank you and praise you for Sister Monalisa Kumar, who is going to celebrate her birthday on 20th. And also Brother Madhusudan Suna, who is also going to celebrate his birthday on 20th. And Suman Saurabh Das, he is also going to celebrate his birthday on 20th. Lord, bless these brothers and sisters. Thank you, O Lord, for granting them a new year in their life. Bless them abundantly. Lord, this time we especially pray for the elders in our church and also in elsewhere. Lord, pray, O Lord, that your very presence continue to be with them. Your grace be sufficient for each one of them. Lord, we pray for our brother R.K. Sahu. Pray for Brother Hirak Kumar Pramanik. Pray, O Lord, that your healing hand would be upon each of them, strengthening them. Lord, you also do pray for other brothers and sisters, those who are weak and maybe in their homes. We pray, O Lord, that your presence will continue to keep them. We pray for Sister Minerva Chan. Thank you, Lord, for being with her during her surgery, and Lord, the success you have granted her. We pray, O Lord, that your healing hand would be upon her and granting her complete recovery from her illness. Lord, we do pray for Brother Ravi Ranjan Raut and Sister Menakhi Raut. Lord, bless your servants and Lord, heal them completely. We also do pray for Brother Subhash Chandra and his wife Subhamani Pradhan. Lord, may your healing hand would be upon them, granting them complete healing. Also, Lord, we pray for all the families, those who are living in COVID zone. We pray, O Lord, that your protection will be upon them. May they be kept safe, O Lord. Lord, we do specially pray for the pandemic that is continuing in the whole world, especially, Lord, in our country and in our state. We pray, O Lord, for all the people, those who have been infected by this virus. Mighty God, have mercy and grant them complete healing. We specially pray for Sister Shraddha Das. Lord, grant her complete healing. Lord, we also do pray for the corona warriors, the doctors and nurses, and Lord, the health workers throughout our country. Bless them abundantly and help them, O Lord. We pray for our government in the center as well as in the state. Lord, bless our leaders. Grant them wisdom during this critical time. Lord, especially, I also do pray for all the students of our community. Lord, some of them have received result, and Lord, thank you for granting them success in their result, O Lord. Bless those children, bless those students, O Lord, as they look forward for further new admission in different schools and colleges. Be with them and guide them, O Lord, and help them. We also do pray for other students, those who are Lord, waiting for their exams to take place. Lord, help them also and grant them your wisdom. We especially pray for our young people, those who are here in this city, as well as in different parts of our country and also in abroad. Lord, continue to, Lord, keep them safe, protect them, be with them and help them, O Lord. Lord, we also do specially pray for all the church activities that is going on. We pray for Mahila Samiti, CE Union, Sunday School, Youth Fellowship. Lord, we pray also for our singing teams, our worship teams, both in Oriya and English Choir. Lord, we pray that you would bless them, bless their ministry. We pray for our church board members, the leadership here, as well as the leadership in various other churches. Pray, O Lord, that your wisdom will be continued to given to them, O Lord. Help them and guide them, O Lord, as they take the responsibility of leading the church. Lord, we also do pray for all our pastors and evangelists, the caretakers of our church as well as in different churches. Bless your servants, O Lord. Help them and strengthen them. And Lord, use them mightily during these days. Lord, we especially pray for the offering, O Lord. We offer this offering and bring it to your feet. Thank you, Lord, for your people who have given so generously and, Lord, out of their willing heart. Bless them abundantly. Use this offering, O Lord, for the glory of your kingdom, for the glory of your name. Help, O Lord. We especially thank you and praise you for your servant, Reverend Dr. Ayub Chhinchani, our beloved pastor. Thank you, Lord, that this morning he is available with us to share from your word. As he stands here, may your Holy Spirit take complete control of him, and may your words and the clarity of thoughts flow through his mouth. And as he speaks, O Lord, may your blessings be upon your people this morning. We give you all glory and honor. We commit each and everything in your hand, O Lord. Thank you for hearing our prayers. In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. We have come into a very important time now. We have been ministering to God thus far, worshiping Him, singing hymns to Him, and praying to Him. But now the Lord is with us to speak to us through His servant. And it is my privilege to invite Reverend Dr. Ayub Chhinchani, our beloved pastor, to come and share from God's word. Reverend Dr. Ayub Chhinchani.
Dear people of God, I greet each one of you in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and I welcome you all to this morning worship service. This morning we are in the presence of God. Even though we are not in the church building, but we are in our homes. But praise God for this wonderful opportunity the Lord has given to us to come to His presence and to worship His name. And this morning, I would like to thank all the brothers and sisters, apart from Union Church, those who have joined with us in this online worship service. May the dear Lord bless you as we worship together in spirit and in truth. This morning, the scripture portion which was read to us by our pastor, Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 26 and 27. Now, Deuteronomy chapter 33 is a wonderful piece of Hebrew poetry. Moses, the man of God, before his death, he pronounced blessing to each tribe of Israel. He gave blessing to each tribe, a particular blessing to sustain them as they experienced the Canaan great benefits and abundance. Now he conclude with a summary of the entire faith and hope of Israel, concentrated and encapsulated in a few short words in verse 24 to 29. These words are not only a beautiful but also word of real brevity and simplicity. The experience of Moses, the help and hope from his relationship with God. Now he wants to pass on that blessing, the final blessing on the 12 tribes of Israel. In this time of fear and anxiety, now as we are going through a time of very dreadful situation, the COVID-19 pandemic, It will be wonderful and refreshing to meditate where our help comes from and what is our hope. Our helps come from the Lord. God is our hope. And this morning, let us meditate the blessing of Moses to the people of Israel. Now this morning, the Lord is going to bless us if we meditate His word. And it is not only the blessing for the people of Israel, but today, this morning, we have the blessing as we meditate God's word. This morning, I would like to tell you that God is our refuge. God is our refuge. And I would like to tell you the first thing, God as our refuge. Now listen to the testimony of this great man of God. Now Moses says, the eternal God is our refuge. He says, the eternal God, the invisible God, He is your refuge. What the meaning refuge means? Normally, it refers to a den or a lair of a wild animal of the desert. For animal, it is a place of protection. Protection from the heat of the sun, protection from the sudden flash flood of the desert, protection from the constant danger of the predators. It is what we can call a home. Now, a den is a home for the animal. For many years, Moses was homeless. He was out in the desert trying to bring a multitude of people safely through to the land of the Canaan. The Lord has given this responsibility to give a leadership to the people of Israel so that He can free them from the slavery of Pharaoh and bring them into the promised land. Now, the wilderness was not a picnic area. It was not a picnic spot. Sometimes people, they go to the picnic for enjoyment, for refreshing. But wilderness journey was a tough journey. Now, the searing heat in the daytime and the freezing temperature at the night. Now, where could Moses find a home in the desert? Now, well, he didn't find a place, but he found a person. Now, in the wilderness journey, he didn't find a place, a home, but he found a person. A person who was everything to him. Jehovah, the God of Israel, was his home. Moses is saying that God was his dwelling place, his home, his protection, his heaven and his refuge. Now, how was this is true? Well, the presence of God in the camp of Israel was revealed. When the people of Israel, they camped one after another on the journey, the presence of God was very much visible in the camp of Israel. Now, by a cloud by daytime and a pillar of fire by nighttime. It was not a celestial firework display, but it was a intensely practical. The cloud kept away the sweltering heat of the sun during the day, and the pillar of fire provided warm at night from freezing cold. God was ministering His people. Where did Moses find food and water for people? God provided them the water from the rock. God provided them manna as their food. The manna was a tasty food, full of vitamins and nutrition, which can keep them healthy. God provided this wonderful food to these people. Now, our food today, they may be very tasty, but they are not good for our body. Sometimes some foods are available in the streets, it is not good for our body. It may be tasteful, but it is not good for our body. God wants the people to enjoy the good food and also to keep themselves healthy. God was to Moses a refuge, a place where all his needs are met. Now, in this COVID-19 pandemic, our government has declared that government will provide extra rice or wheat for the poor people of our country for 3 months. But the amazing thing that God did not provided them for 1 week or 1 month or even a year. God did provided them for from one generation to another generation. From one generation, for 40 years, God provided them in the wilderness the manna and the water from the rock and also the meat. Now, the Jewish people, they are fond of eating meat. God provided them meat and everything. The older generation, they died in the wilderness, and the new generation came. When the new generation came, God was faithful to the new generation by providing all their needs in the journey. From generation to generation, the Lord is their eternal refuge. My dear brothers and sisters, this morning let me tell you, God is our refuge. God is with us and God is our refuge. And this morning, let us thank the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge. In the times of fear, in the times of the anxiety and worries, what is going to happen? We do not know. But one thing we know as a people of God, we can trust Him that He is our refuge. He is with us. The second thing which I'd like to tell you is the ground of our refuge. Now, Moses pointed out the twin pillar of creation and covenant as the foundation of this truth. Now, if you read verse 26, there it is written, "There is no one like the Lord of Jeshurun, who raised the heaven to help you, and in excellency on the cloud." No, Moses was writing as the people of Israel was on the verge of entering into Canaan. This blessing was pronounced as the people are in the verge to enter into Canaan. Now, their economy was based on entirely on farming and raising sheep. Their economy was based on agriculture and raising sheep. The essential element was rain they needed. They needed rain. Now, in our times also today, our farmer, they need rains to cultivate and to do farming. Not enough rain means the drought and death. Too much rain means flood and death. Now, the Canaanite people, they worship the idol called Baal. They they believe that their idol Baal is a rain god. If they could keep him happy, they could control the rain and enjoy the good life. But Baal was not God. The Canaanite people, they worship idol. The God of Israel is the creator God. The God of Israel, the God of Bible is the God who created. He is the creator, He is the sustainer, and He is the living God. And it is Israel God who write the cloud. He is the one who made everything. And He is the giver of life. Only He can guarantee the good life for you and for me. This morning, only the Lord can give the guarantee, the good life for you and for me. What they needed? They needed the rain. What you need? We need the eternal. Our God is the eternal refuge. My dear brothers and sisters, this morning, we need the former rain and the latter rain. We need the rain of the Holy Spirit in our life. We need the power of God in our life. We need the presence of God in our life. Because God is our eternal refuge. In this time of fear, If you want to lead a victorious life, if you want to be free from your anxiety, free from your worries, you need to make God as your eternal refuge. And God is our eternal refuge. The Hebrew word for God is Elohim, which means it's a mighty God, the strength of God, all-powerful. Our God is an all-powerful God. He can keep us from every harm. He can protect us from every evils. The Lord is with His people, and the blessing is upon us. We are also told He is a God of covenant. Who is Yeshurun? Where does this word come from? Yeshurun is the poetical name or a nickname for Israel. And it speaks of special intimacy or a close relationship. Now God is giving a nickname or a pet name to Israel. That Israel and God, they are having a very close, intimate relationship. Now today, we call our wife or husband or our children, we don't call them in their name, but we have some pet name. And we call them different name. That means he speaks that we have a very close, intimate relationship. Now this relationship is very special. It's a special love, enduring loyalty, and explicit trust. He is a covenant-keeping God. He said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. My dear brothers and sisters, let me encourage you in this time of the COVID-19 pandemic. Let me tell you, He says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. The Almighty God is with us. The Almighty God, His hand is upon us. He is our refuge and strength. Now, if you look to Psalm, David says, the Lord is my refuge and strength. The Lord is my light. The Lord is the strength of my life. My dear brothers and sisters, the eternal God, He has promised He will never leave us and never forsake us. Today, by faith in Jesus Christ, God became our refuge. God became our refuge. When you have put your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, the day when you have committed your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, you became the property of God. You belongs to Christ, and Christ has every right. And He not only right, He protects you, He provides you, and He guides you, He leads you, and He fills your life with all spiritual blessing, with all blessing that you needed. Thirdly, I would like to mention is the complete range of our refuge. The complete range. What is the range of our refuge? Moses says, the eternal God is your refuge. The eternal God is our refuge. God is spoken of as the eternal God. He is the eternal God. Now, I imagine this way. By the time when Moses was pronouncing this blessing, he was an old man. By the power of God and by the help of God and by the instruction of God, He led the people of Israel out of the slavery, and he has given them a freedom. Now for 40 years, He was like a father to the nation of Israel. People dependent upon Him for everything. Now, like the little children, as they depend upon their parents, the children of Israel, they depended upon Moses. They had given him much trouble, much problems. Many times they have thrown a stone towards him. They want to disobey him. But he was very caring. Like a father, like a mother, he was very caring to the people of Israel. Once God said, Moses, you leave these people. These people of Israel are stiff-necked people. I want to destroy them, but I want to establish you. Do you know what Moses said? a true leader. He said, if you want to leave these people, if you want to destroy these people, first of all, please strike my name in your book of life. What kind of heart? Now, Moses was a father to the children of Israel. Now, Moses is going to die. His age has come, now Moses is going to die. And after death, what will happen to the people of Israel? Now, Joshua will lead the people. Whether the Israelite will, they will obey Joshua or not, whether they will follow the instruction of the Lord or not. Now, God tells to Moses, Moses, you have done enough. Moses, you are a faithful servant and you have served me. And Moses, now I want you to take rest. I'm going to put your body to rest. In the midst of these worries, he found the comfort. My friend, sometimes God tells us to take rest, to take off. You know, in this situation, in this coronavirus situation, the positive side of this virus is, I see many families are gathered together and the family prayers are rising up, and many are committed to the family prayers and reading the Bible together. And they are growing in spiritual life. Now, God is saying, Moses, take rest. In the midst of all this, all his worries, he found a comfort. God would still be with them. God will be for them. God is going to travel with them. God is never grow old. God never get weary. He is the same unchanging God. The Bible says, Jesus Christ is same today, tomorrow, yesterday, today and tomorrow. He is the unchanging God. My dear brothers and sisters, our faith is on the unchanging Savior. From everlasting to everlasting, He is the God, the same God. What a wonderful comfort we have. This morning, what a wonderful God we serve. Let us trust Him. Let us put our faith on Him. Let us worship Him. Let us come closer to our God, because our God is an everlasting God. He is from everlasting to everlasting. He is the same God. Now, when the children, they lose their parents, what remains? Now, very recently I read in a newspaper, in an Odia newspaper, they came from Hyderabad, a couple, they came from Hyderabad and they were in the quarantine. And the husband found to be positive, but the wife also was in the quarantine. The husband was dead. After hearing the death of news of her husband, she committed suicide. My dear brothers and sisters, when everything is gone, what remains? But for the people of God, maybe they don't have anything. But we as a believer in Christ, we as the people of God, when the foundation of life are shaken, when life is turned upside and down, when the world is shattered, when our dreams are shattered, for a Christian believer, God is there. He is willing and able to help and deal with all the problem that causes us to fear. The Lord is with us in every troubles, in every problems, in every difficult situation. He will never leave us, and He is with us. My dear brothers and sisters, He is there to wipe out all your tears. He's there to give you His joy and His peace and His happiness. Our God is such a wonderful God, and we serve a wonderful God. We need to know this comfort, because uncertainty and fear assault every one of us in different way. There are fear of the past, fear about the present, and fear about the future. fear of sin and sickness, fear of sorrow and death, there are open fears, disguised fear and unfounded fear. We need a refuge, and God is our refuge. God is our refuge. The final point I would like to tell, and I would like to close my sermon. Fourthly, the guarantee of our refuge. The guarantee of our refuge. The eternal God who provides salvation also provides a continuing care. He not only saved us, but He is eternal, and He promised that He will be with us till the end of the age. My friend, the day when we accepted Jesus Christ as our personal Lord and Savior, we received salvation. He has provided us salvation, but He will also continue to give us His care and His provision and His blessing upon us. The eternal God is your refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arm. The Bible says, the eternal God is your refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arm. Whose arm? God's arm. And nobody can snatch away from His arm. He's a personal God. Though we worship together as a church, but our God is a personal God. You need to make your personal relationship with Jesus Christ. My friend, it is not a corporate religion. It is, yes, we corporately worship. We corporately praise His name, but we need to make a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. And our God is a personal God who blesses us. Now, there are certain ministries which depute. No, in the ministry of God, there are some ministries which the Lord does through the angel. But some ministry, He has no deputies. When angel was sent to Nazareth and all other places to announce the birth of Lord Jesus Christ, no, it was the angel who took the message. But here we see the Almighty God. Almighty God is with us. Many things He does through His people, but something He does personally for His people. Something He does for His people personally. My dear brothers and sisters, the everlasting arm of God is underneath. His hand is underneath. He is there to carry us. He is there to bless us. He is there to provide us. I read a story about a pastor when he finished his university education and returned home. Now, after the dinner, when he was ready to go to bed, his mother asked her son, "Son, are you warm enough?" Because it was cold country. The mother asked, "Son, are you warm enough? Do you need another blanket?" Now the pastor knew, the pastor is grown up, and he knew where the blanket is. But his mother was very keen to give a personal care. My brothers and sisters, our God is like that. Our God is who takes personal interest, personal care. Though He is an eternal God, His hand is upon us. The eternal God is your refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arm. This everlasting arm means that you will never be in any situation as a child of God where the Lord isn't available to you. No matter what your experience may be, no matter what happens to you, however dark or deep your situation may be, always for the child of God, underneath are the everlasting arm. How safe, how blessed, how comforting it is. My dear brothers and sisters, this morning, God is our refuge. God is our strength. The eternal God is your refuge.
and underneath are the everlasting arm. Let us trust upon Him and let us commit our life to Him so that we can experience and enjoy His blessing upon our life. Shall we look to the Lord in prayer? Let's pray. Gracious God, our loving Father, our refuge and strength, this morning we come to your throne of grace. Lord, you are our eternal God, the invisible Father, the creator of heaven and earth, our sustainer, our redeemer. Lord, your hands are upon us, O Lord, and underneath your mighty eternal hand is upon us, O Lord. And we thank you, God, for carrying us. In this situation, O Lord, we believe that you, our God, you always carry your people, O Lord. O Lord, once again, we commit ourselves into your hand. Lord, you bless us and help us, Lord, to trust you in every situation, in every trials and difficulties, that we may experience your presence and your power and your deliverance. Bless us together, O Lord. Thank you for listening to our prayer. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Thank you. May God bless you.
The Lord has spoken to us this morning, and He has blessed us through His word. Let us respond to the word of God that we have heard, committing ourselves into the hand of the Lord. May the Holy Spirit take this word and use in our life, bring forth much fruit in our lives. Let us pray. Dear Lord, our Heavenly Father, thank you for being with us throughout this worship service. Thank you also, Lord, for using your servant mightily this morning. Lord, we commit him into your hand. Continue to bless him, bless his family, and bless the ministry that you have entrusted him to carry out. Be with your servant, O Lord. As all of us, we have heard your clear-cut voice this morning. We pray and commit ourselves, Lord, in your hands, that you, your Holy Spirit, may continue to work in our lives. Continue to bless our lives. May your word bring forth much fruit in our lives. Lord, we commit ourselves once again, and we offer this prayer in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us receive the benediction. Now may the love of the Father, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us this morning in online worship service. God bless you all. Have a great week.